We live in a digitally connected world that is driven by software solutions, even in modern cars. So adding any new feature should be easy, right? For example, customizing the turn indicator pattern of a car that can even be configured by the driver. However, it's actually not that simple for an OEM to do so, since several hard and software suppliers are involved. Even if the hardware is capable, the turn indicator ECU definitely needs a software update to be able to switch patterns. In order to introduce new signals, which change the communication on the bus, the gateway needs to be adjusted. Additionally, an app is required for the configuration on the dashboard, which can also process the signals. So even a minor change, like adapting the indicator pattern, is time and cost-consuming. So how can the software-defined vehicle enable future innovations? To expand and update features after production, the vehicle needs to be designed to do so from the beginning. The goal is to allow fast and cost-efficient changes within the car. At Vector, we see five necessary enablers for software-defined vehicles. First, the EE architecture of our cars must be adapted, since the SDV is based on a centralized HPC and zonal architecture. Second, the capacity of the used hardware needs to increase to process all functionalities, even the ones we're unaware of today. Third, a software base layer is needed, a superset of basic software for in-vehicle HPCs, zonals, and back-end. Fourth, a software factory with suitable tools and workflows to enable collaborating engineers to work productively in fast release cycles. And most importantly, humans are the foundation of this process. If you want to put an SDV on the road successfully, you need trained and certified people working with one another. Here's the good news. Vector supports you on your way to modern vehicle platforms driven by software solutions. Contact us now to learn more about the smart way to design SDV.